पेज नंबर 269 क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 कैश बुक ऑफ आदित्य शोज बैलेंस ऑफ रुपीज 9000 ऑन 31/10/13 विच डज नॉट टैली विद बैंक बैलेंस एज पर पासबुक प्रिपेयर आदित्य's बैंक रिकंसिलिएशन स्टेटमेंट फ्रॉम द इंफॉर्मेशन गिवन बिलो. नाउ हाउ डू वी मेक द वर्किंग्स कैश बुक पासबुक बैंक बैलेंस ओवरड्राफ्ट रिसिप्ट्स पेमेंट्स डेबिट क्रेडिट क्रेडिट डेबिट डेबिट क्रेडिट क्रेडिट डेबिट. स्टेप वन वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इज इट अ रिसिप्ट और पेमेंट. स्टेप टू वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इन विच बुक इज इट नॉट रिकॉर्डेड. ओके नाउ इन द बिगनिंग कैश बुक ऑफ आदित्य शोज बैंक बैलेंस ऑफ रुपीज 9000 ऑन 31/10/15 अंडरलाइन कैश बुक अंडरलाइन बैलेंस. सो रिया हाउ डू वी स्टार्ट. Yes, correct. So now we are into bank balance. See here, bank balance as per cash book. Where should we write? Okay, so we'll start with that. Head on. Bank balance as per cash book. In debit column 9000. Any confusions in this? All okay with it? Next one. Jamin. Checks of. Okay, now we have prepared Aditya's bank reconciliation statement from the information given below first. Checks of 51,000 were deposited, out of which checks of 41,000 were credited in bank till 31/10/15. Just by the illustrations, you will ask this doubt. What about? Wrong. Mansi? Correct. We render. And then 41,000 were credited in bank till 31/10/15. Out of 51,000 deposited, 41,000 is credited in passbook. What is not credited in passbook? 10,000. So 10,000 will be credited in BIS. We deposited checks of 51,000 means in cash book we have debited 51,000. But in passbook only 41,000 is credited. What is not credited in passbook? 10,000 that we have to credit in BIS. Did anyone of you understand this? So underline 41,000 were credited in bank and write down 10,000 not credited. Write down 10,000 not credited. So this 10,000 we have to credit in BIS. Okay. First reason, checks deposited but not yet collected by the bank. So 10,000 is not credited in passbook, we will credit in BIS. Raise your hand who did not understand this. All okay with it? Now look at the second one. Rami, check of 2,300 is drawn and recorded in cash book but not yet given to creditor.
Check drawn but not given to creditor on debit side 2,300.
Correct. First of all, drawn means issue. So is it a receipt or a payment?
Payment.
And not given to creditor means in which book it is not recorded? Passbook. Because until you give it to the creditor, it cannot be deposited in the bank. So it is a payment and not recorded in passbook. We will write on debit side. When we have drawn or issued the check, we have credited in cash book. But But we forgot to give it to the creditor, so it is not debited in passbook, so debited TRS. Did anyone understand this? So print out checks drawn, but not yet given to the creditor. So 2300 is credited in cash book, but not debited in passbook, so debited DRS. Anyone having any doubt in this, raise your hand. Or are you able to understand? Okay, apply your logic, think it properly. Is it a receipt or a payment? Then think it properly, in which book it is not recorded. It is very simple to get the answers. Next. Wait. Bank has paid 1700 for insurance premium through electronic clearing service, which is not recorded in cash book. Correct, very good. Pay random. First of all, is it a receipt or a payment? And then bank has paid payment, clearly given. Bank has paid means it is a payment. And it is clearly given at the end and then not recorded in cash book. So payment, not recorded in cash book, where will we write? Credit side. Bank has paid the money, so bank has debited in passbook, but it is not yet credited in cash book, so credited DRS. Okay. So third reason, insurance premium directly paid by the bank. Insurance premium directly paid by the bank. Since it is directly paid by the bank, 1700 is debited in passbook but not yet credited in cash book, so credited in DRS. Any doubts up till here? Next. Okay, Megha. A customer has deposited 3200 directly in Aditya's bank account, which is known to him on 2nd November 2013.
Amount directly deposited by a customer in bank account, 3200 in debit.
Correct. So, Ramya Render, see, known to Aditya on 2nd November, we are making DRS for 31st October. Means Aditya did not know it in October. So, it is not recorded in which book? Cash book. Aditya did not know about that in October. So, it is not recorded in cash book. Aditya, bank has paid the money, received the money. Aditya came to know in November. Aditya did not know in October means it is not recorded in cash book. Trader does not know it. Now, customer has deposited the money in our bank account. So, is it a receipt or a payment? Receipt. We are receiving the money. Customer has deposited in our bank account. It is a receipt and not recorded in cash book. So, where will we record? Is everyone clear with this? So, fourth reason. Customer directly deposited the amount in our bank account. So 3200 is credited in passbook but not debited in cash book, so debited DRS. Any doubts up till fourth? Next, fifth. Sana, bank charges recorded by bank rupees 70 is recorded twice in cash book by mistake. I explained this, you know. It's a new one. It's basically a rectification of error, like yesterday also we did overcasting and undercasting. Overcasting? Opposite side. Undercasting? Same side. Now this one will also come in the summary notes. Not in the summary, no notes. Bank charges recorded by bank 70 is recorded twice in cash book by mistake. Understand what has happened here? Cash book and passbook. Where will bank charges appear in passbook? This is receipt, this is payment. This is receipt, this is payment. Where will bank charges appear in passbook? Debit side. How much are the bank charges bank has recorded? 70. Any doubts with this? Now, where should it appear in cash book? credit side. Now see, read it, what has happened. Bank charges recorded by the bank 70 is recorded online twice in cash book by mistake. 70 we have recorded by mistake two times. Okay, maybe accountant was writing the books of accounts. He already recorded 70 rupees on the payment side. Suddenly got a call from his wife, and as regular something happened. And after that, again he recorded 70 on the payment side after the call. So by mistake, he has recorded same amount how many times? Two times. Now how will he rectify this? Reverse it once. How will you rectify this? You know, can this 170 is already correct? One amount of 70 is already correct. Which is extra amount on the right side? That you have to reverse and write on the debit side. So what will you do to rectify this 70 rupees we will debit in DIS? Did you understand this portion, everyone? So if any amount is recorded twice, how will you rectify it? Reverse it once. Suppose they say interest of 30 recorded in passbook is recorded twice in cash book, then 30 rupees you reverse it one means. Where you write it? So how you rectify this will do in detail in part 2, accounts chapter 1. There is a chapter on rectification of accounts where we will study such several rules in details. So there also it will help you. Whenever there is an error of recording twice, what will you do? Reverse it once. Is everyone clear with it? And normal concept. Suppose you have to go to Alkapuri 3 kilometers. By mistake, you travel 6 kilometers. What will you do now? Come back 3 kilometers. So, reverse it once. Did anyone of you understand this? Any doubts on it? So, remind me, I'll make you write it in the notes later on. Show this working slide. Now, this is for transaction number 5. Okay, this is for transaction number 5. Bank charges of 70 recorded in passbook. Bank charges will always come on payment section. Passbook will come on debit side. But by mistake it is recorded in cash book twice. Means in cash book on the payment side we have recorded 70 and 70 how many times? Two times. Now one amount of 70 is already correct. We have to cancel this one extra amount of 70 which we have recorded. So that you reverse and write on which side? Debit side. Okay, so now this 70 rupees we have to write on which side? Debit side. Means bank charges wrongly recorded twice in cash book. Bank charges wrongly recorded twice in cash book. So 70 now you will reverse and write on debit side. Did you understand this? Anyone having any doubt in it? This is also a reason of difference. Because of this, cash book and passbook balance will not match. Because in cash book we have made the same entry two times, so it's quite obvious the closing balance of cash book will not match with that of passbook. Okay. Next. Check of 6750 deposited with the bank on 27th October 2015 is dishonored. You make this work, games? The information of which is received by Aditya on 1-11-15. Okay, now, raise your hand. How will we make it? Two times we practiced it already yesterday. 6750 check is deposited and dishonored. How will we make the workings? Raise your hand. Kritika.
Sir, check is deposited in bank. So first we collect it, so it is received for us. So we record on debit side in cash.
First of all, we deposited the check means we would have received the check. So check of 6750 we will write in debit side of cash book. Any doubts with this? Then
for bank, in past the bank will record it in credit side.
Now, even if it is dishonored, first bank will make the entry in passbook on credit side.
So the check will be dishonored check is now based on, so the entry would be reversed. So we
bank will reverse and write it on debit side because the check is dishonored. Then
the 6750 is debited in passbook but not credited in cashbook, so will credit in BIS.
Correct. 6750 is debited in passbook but not credited in cashbook, so we will credit in
BIS.
Are we are confident with this now? Two times we have done it yesterday. Make these workings. Make it those who have not done. Whenever there is a dishonor, we make these workings so that you remember it for exams point of view. Okay? And when you revise, you must be able to understand how is it done. Anyone who wants me to explain it again? All are clear with the 6-1? So, 6-1, checks deposited and dishonored. But not recorded in cash book. Checks deposited and dishonored but not recorded in cash book. So 6750 is debited in passbook but not credited in cash book. So credited in BIS. Anyone have any doubt on this? All are clear with it? Raise your hand who wants me to explain the 6-1 again. Look at the 7th 1 now. Check of 4780. I can ask anyone to be attentive. Check of 4780 were drawn, out of which check of 1770 were presented in bank on 2nd November 2015. Haribol. Seven. What amount? Wrong. So now 1770 will be read it carefully. Check of 4780 were drawn. First of all, drawn means
issued.
Out of it, check of 1770 and line were presented in bank on 2nd November. We are making BRS for 31st October. 1770 are presented in November means they are not presented in October. So we have to directly record 1770. If it was given 1770 are presented up till 31st October, then we would have taken difference amount. That 1770 are recorded up till October, remaining is not recorded. But here 1770 is presented on 2nd November. Means 1770 is not appearing in passbook up till 31st October. You understand it? It is different from the one you had in homework. There it was given presented up till 31st October. So we took difference amount, not presented. But here it is given 1770 is presented on 2nd of November. Means that 1770 is not recorded in passbook in the month of October. Did you understand this question, everyone? So underline were presented in bank on 2nd November 2015 and write down on the right side, not presented up to 31-10-15. Not presented up to 31-10-15. So we will debit 1770. First of all, tell me drawn means
issued
means it is a payment, and not presented up till October means it is not recorded in passbook. So we will debit. But we will debit 1770 itself. Is everyone clear with this? So write down 7th reason. Checks issued but not yet presented for payment. Checks issued but not yet presented for payment. So 1770 is credited in cash book but not yet debited in passbook. We will debit in BIS. Did everyone understand it? Raise your hand who is not clear with it. Next. Check of 1320 was deposited in the bank, but it is not recorded in cash book. This check is not collected by bank till 31-10-15. No effect. Understand this? Check of 1320 was deposited in bank, but underline, it is not recorded in the cash book. It is not recorded in cash book. We only deposited the check and we only forgot to record in cash book. And this check is even not collected by the bank till 31st. October means it is also not recorded in passbook. And then not collected by bank till 31st October and then not recorded in passbook. Now if any amount is neither appearing in cash book nor appearing in passbook, then is it a reason of difference between the closing balance? It will not come in BRS. It will come in next month's BRS. Where it will be there in passbook, but it will not be there in cash book. Did you understand this? This one will not appear in BRS because it is neither recorded in cash book nor in passbook. Any doubts with this? As such in exams, even if you don't write, it's okay. But right now for understanding, note it down. No effect. Reason, neither is it recorded in cash book nor it is recorded in passbook. Raise your hand if you did not understand this. All okay with it? Next. Bank has credited 130 for interest and debited 60 for bank charges in passbook, which is underlying not recorded in cashbook. We will write two separate reasons for this. So, Vishal.
Sir, bank has credited interest but not in passbook, but in cashbook it is not debited, so we will debit in BRS. And bank has debited bank charges in passbook, but it is not credited in cashbook, so we will credit in BRS.
Correct. So now, and then credited 130. So 130 of interest is credited in passbook but not debited in cashbook, so debit in BRS. Okay, two reasons will come here. First, interest directly credited by the bank. Interest directly credited by the bank. So 130 is credited in passbook but not debited in cashbook. We will debit in BRS. And underline, debited 60. Bank has debited 60 for bank charges means it is debited in passbook but not credited in cashbook, so credited in BRS. So 9B, bank charges directly debited by the bank. Bank charges directly debited by the bank. 60 is debited in passbook but not credited in cashbook, so credited in BRS. Any doubts on this? Next, 10th. This we studied yesterday, raise your hand. Total of receipt side of cashbook is overcast by rupees 900. Anyone else? Receipt side of cashbook, sure. Correct. All of you have the receipt side of cashbook. There is debit side. Write down about that debit. Receipt side of cashbook is debit side. Write down about that debit. And then overcast. Now overcast means write down same size or opposite side. So about overcast, write credit. Means what will we do with it? Credit rupees 900. Okay. Overcasting on the receipt side of cashbook. Overcasting on the receipt side of cash book. So now overcasting means we'll write on the opposite side. So 900 will write on the credit side. Overcasting is done on debit side, so we'll write on credit side. Undercasting write on same side, overcasting write on opposite side. Any confusions? Now this we have done earlier. Who will explain it? Bills receivable of 1200 discounted with the bank is dishonored on 28th October 2015 and bank debited this amount with noting charges of rupees 20. But entry for dishonor is not made in cash book till 31/10/15. So who will explain this 11th one? Raise your hand. This is similar to the 6th one. That's it. So two people are clear with dishonor transactions. Madhura. Yes, first of all, when we discount the bills with the bank, what did I tell you yesterday? Discounting of bills with bank means what?
Advance.
Yes, we take the money from bank in advance. Bills are going to mature in future. Bank has given 1200 rupees in advance. Okay, very clear. Discounted the bills with the bank means we will write in cash book on debit side, 1200. Bank will deposit in our account, so bank will credit 1200 in passbook.
But it is dishonored, so the entry
will reverse. It is dishonored, so bank will reverse and write on debit side 1200.
And noting charges of 20.
Also along with noting charges of 20.
But it is not credited in cashbook.
But it is not yet credited in cashbook, so credited VRS. So, is everyone clear with this? Okay, noting charges, I told you to get the notary done with the legal advocate so that you can file a suit in the court of law. So, 1200 when we discount the bills with the bank in cash book, it comes on the debit side. In passbook, it comes on the credit side. When it is dishonored, bank will know about that first. So, bank will reverse and write on debit side 1200. Along with noting charges also, they take from our account 20 rupees. 1220 is debited in passbook but not credited in cash book. So, credited. Yes. Any doubts with this? So bills discounted with the bank dishonored who is talking in between? Bills discounted with the bank dishonored along with noting charges not yet recorded in cash book. So 1220 is debited in passbook but not yet credited in cash book, so credited in VRS. Any doubts with this? All are clear with it? Then, last one is new now, be it ended. Understand it properly. Mark it important also. Bills payable, rupees 700, maturing after 1 month, was retired by the bank under rebate of rupees 30. On 30th October 2015, which is not recorded in cash book. Now, understand this. Bills payable. Retired by the bank means paid early by the bank. Retired by the bank means paid early. For example, I have given bills payable. Listen carefully. I have given bills payable of 700 to Mudra, which I have to pay after 1 month. Now, I have the money. So, I ask Mudra that you collect the money right now. Maybe 1 month later I may not have it. Right now I have the money, so I want to fulfill my habit. I am supposed to pay the money to Mudra after 1 month. I have already given the bills. The bills are going to mature after 1 month. And I am asking her to get the money right now, take the money right now. So, she gives me discount, 30 rupees. Because I am paying 1 month early, so instead of 700 I have to pay 600. And I give the instructions to the bank that 1 month early the bill is retired, so at the discount of 30, you give the money. So bank directly pays to Mudra, but what amount?
670.
Now, is it a receipt or a payment?
Payment.
For us, it is a payment. We are paying 1 month early. Is it or not? For us, it is a payment. Who makes the payment?
Bank.
So bank will record it. Passbook and is given not recorded in cash book.
Yes.
And then It is a payment and not recorded in cash book. So where will you write credit side? But what amount?
670.
Rebate of 30. So I'll rebate and write discount. Since we are paying 1 month early, it is maturing after 1 month. We are paying 1 month early, so there is a discount of 30. Instead of 700, we are paying 670. But bank has paid 670. So it is debited in passbook, but not yet credited in cash book. So credit in.
Yes.
Any doubts with this? So 12th reason, bills payable paid by the bank at rebate. So in bracket you can show 700 minus rebate of 30. So 670 is debited in passbook but not yet credited in cash book. So credit in DRS. Anyone having any doubt on this? All are clear with this one? Now which side looks more? Credit side looks more? No, debit is more. No, credit is more. 610. 10, 11, 17, 18, 19, 400, 20,300, 500, 21,100, 21,210, 21,300. Or is it like 21,300 on both the sides? Do you all get credit side total 21,300? Now 21,300, do it minus 9,000, minus 2,300, minus 3,200, minus 70, 1770 and 130. 4830. Is everyone clear with this? Now this 4830, Sudhi, what do we call this as? 4830.
Bank balance
as per?
Passbook.
We started with?
Cash book.
We started with cash book, so we'll end with? Passbook. Now you get the answer in? Debit column. What is passbook's debit? So what will we write? Bank overdraft as per passbook. Did you understand this portion, everyone? Not bank balance, bank overdraft as per passbook. And I told you earlier also, it is not necessary that if you start with bank balance, then in answer will come bank balance only. Okay, one more time I repeated, we started with
cash book.
So we'll end with passbook. Which column do you get the answer?
Debit.
What is passbook's debit balance called? Bank. Any confusions in that?